Hi, it's Graphics Calculator Gamer. This video is a tutorial on how to install and use PicoDrive 1.35 on your TI-Nspire or TI-Nspire CX. PicoDrive is a Sega MegaDrive aka Genesis emulator that has been ported to Nspire. To install PicoDrive, it is necessary to have Endless 3.1 or above installed on your TI-Nspire. If you haven't got Endless, then please view my video on how to install it. To download PicoDrive, visit this website. I have the link in the video description as always. Next, download any ROMs that you'd like to play on your calculator. To download ROMs, go to this website which I have linked in the video description. Once PicoDrive and your ROMs are downloaded onto your computer, extract the zip files. The next step is to convert the ROMs to TNS format. TNS is the format that files must be in for the calculator to accept them. To do this, open the folder containing the ROM and make sure the box next to File Name Extensions and File Explorer is checked. Then rename the ROM with .tns on the end. Click Yes. The file can now be transferred onto the Nspire. Open TI-Nspire Computer Link software on your computer. It is available for both PC and Mac, and can be downloaded for free from the link in the description. Plug your TI-Nspire into your computer, and once TI-Nspire Computer Link software loads, click Refresh. Then click Select. I recommend creating a new folder on your calculator to put PicoDrive and your ROMs in. Once you have done this, find PicoDrive.tns and your ROMs in the top box and drag them into the correct directory on the calculator. You should now receive a message on your TI-Nspire reading that the file has been received. On the TI-Nspire, open PicoDrive and navigate to the ROM you would like to play. The buttons are mapped as follow: Touchpad equals Dpad, Ctrl equals A, Shift equals B, and Var equals C. I will have written this in the description, and it can also be found in the README file in PicoDrive Nspire. 6 button games are not properly supported yet. As you can see, the game runs well. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have any questions, please ask me in the comments and let me know what you'd like to do next.